If you get neck pain or pain into your shoulder or down your arm all the way into your hands, it could be caused by a problem in your neck. So I just wanted to take a minute here to show you a couple cervical spine x-rays or neck x-rays, because most people have never actually seen what an x-ray looks like. So this is an x-ray of someone's neck or cervical spine. And structure is important because it dictates function. You can see this every day in someone's posture. So someone who's slouched over versus someone who's nice and tall and straight and symmetrical. You know, the person who has better posture is more likely to have better health and better function. So when it comes to, for example, radiculopathy, which can be nerve pain into the arm or down in the hand, it can be caused by structural distortions in the neck, which are often misdiagnosed as like carpal tunnel or weakness in the hands or a rotator cuff problem or a shoulder problem. So three important things we need to note before we start. When we're looking at the neck from the side, this is the skull here, this is the jaw, these are the teeth out front. You're looking for three things in the neck. You're looking for a nice C-shaped curve, kind of like a banana. You want nice square bones and a nice space between the bones. So if we take a look at this x-ray, here I'll kind of give you an example of what that nice C-shaped curve should look like. It should look like this. So the bones in the neck should have a nice curve in them, as your neck should have a lordosis, which is kind of like that banana shape there. So you can see we've lost that lordosis here. If I were to draw what that looks like, you can see all the bones line up and stack up straight in the neck. The other thing we're looking for, again, are nice square-shaped bones. You can see the bones here are nice and square in shape. And if we move down here, you can see that there's actually a bone spur happening. So the bone has started to get sharp, and you're getting a bone spur. So if I were to draw that on here, you can see it's sharpened right in this area here. And then the one above it, you've got this bone spur happening right there. So that's the body putting down more calcium and bone, because that segment has not been moving properly because there's been a restriction, or as we call a subluxation. We're also looking for a nice fat disc space. So the disc space, which allows the nerves to come out, right here you can see they're nice and wide, but down here it's starting to thin and narrow. So that would be some degenerative disc disease happening there with some bone spurring in the front. So I just want to show you one last film. This is looking at the neck on an angle. So up top here you can see the skull again. This is the jaw out front. And these are the bones or the vertebrae. And so we're kind of looking in like this. We're looking to see if those nerves that are exiting out of the vertebral canals there, the foramina, if they have enough room or space. So if we look here, these are the spaces or the intervertebral foramina, basically the holes where the nerves come out. So they should be nice and round and patent like this, so that the nerve has lots of space. It's not getting compressed as it's coming out of the neck. I'll do a little bit of drawing here. The nerve canal should look like this one right here. Nice and big and round with lots of space. And this one here. But if we come all the way down here, we can see that there's a bone spur here protruding back into that canal, which is causing it to sort of look like an upside down boot. And if I zoom in, you get a better view. So you can see there's about a 50% loss of space here due to that bone spur that's protruding into that neural canal. To give you a little bit more background, this patient who came in here was a lady in her mid 40s who had been having numbness and tingling down her right arm into her right hand for about 6 or 7 years. She'd had 5 carpal tunnel surgeries and was still getting that numbness and tingling. So you can see the problem there, and it exists in her neck. And so we help people with problems like that all the time. And usually this has been a problem that's been there for a long time, but no one ever thought to look into the neck. And so we know that the brain and the nerve system controls all our functions. We just want to make sure that your brain is able to talk to your body, and it does so through those nerves, and that allows for better health. So I hope you found this interesting and useful. If you have any questions at all, please comment in the box below, or send me a message or give me a call. You can reach me at the office, 519-669-5571. And again, I'm Dr. Thom Green from Elmira Family Chiropractic. Have a great day.